You know the drill. There are hundreds of iron farm designs and you can't decide on which one to build. Well, in this video I'm gonna show you 6 iron farm designs that range all the way from the super easy ones you could build in the first few hours of a new world, to more advanced ones, and all the way to super advanced ones that we build on mechanists. Starting with this one, it produces 44 iron per hour and you literally don't need anything to build it. Once you find a village, you are ready to build this farm. If we look underground, we have 5 villagers with beds, and at the top here, we only let golems spawn in this 3x3 area here. The other blocks surrounding it are too high up, and they immediately suffocate because of this block in the middle here, and they just spawn in it. They don't care about it, they spawn in it, they die, and we don't even need a collection system. You can just hop in, get your iron, and it's done. A tutorial on this one is in the description. Moving on, we have a similar design that's more efficient though. So it also uses the villagers' underground trick more or less. And the golems this time have all the space around to spawn though. So they are not limited by this 3x3 area. They can spawn anywhere where the villagers would allow them to. And also they get flushed outside of the range of the villagers. So the villagers can't detect the golems anymore because they are flushed out. So they can spawn a new golem way earlier than with this one. Also here the iron golems get killed on a campfire, which is also very cheap. You could also add a lava source, but if you have lava, there are better designs to build. The items just get collected in a chest on the other side with a hopper underneath the campfire. And the farm produces 120 iron per hour. A tutorial on this farm is in the video description as well. And moving on, we have a very compact and fast one. This one produces almost 260 iron per hour. And so this villager and zombie setup is really smart. I saw that on IanXO4's channel. I'll also link his video in the description. He used the setup with the zombie in a boat a little different though. In this case, it needs to be built in the air though, otherwise iron golems would spawn at the bottom here. And the setup itself works by the villagers not being able to see the zombie only in one of the 6 spots on the beds here. So if they stand in the middle here, they can't see the zombie through the trapdoor. But on any other spot where they could be, they can see the zombie and are scared therefore. Also at night, they would actually get sleep since they can't see the zombie while they are behind this trapdoor, which allows them to enter any of the 3 beds. Once they lay down though, they can see the zombie again and are scared again. So this farm also works day and night, and that's also part of the reason why it's so fast. At the top here we have a simple flushing system with lava that kills the golems, which is fast enough to not stop them from spawning new golems. The items just get collected with hoppers into a chest. And also those walls are necessary so the golems don't spawn inside of blocks here and get stuck. Moving on to Gnambon's design here, which is a really nice mix of easy to build, but it still produces a ton of items. In my case here, I get 6,000 iron per hour. I think he said that it should do 9,000. There might be a chance that I messed something up when copying it, but maybe also something changed between 1.16.2 and 1.16.5. I'm not sure about that. It uses one hostile mob, a pillager in this case, which has a higher range than a zombie that scares the villagers. We have 5 platforms with 4 cells and 3 villagers each. And those most of the time spawn 4 golems once the pillager arrives at their platform. And the pillager just goes around here through those 5 platforms every time. So the farm also works at night and it's also really efficient. The pillager always waits roughly 5 seconds at each platform and then it moves on. Also the track is covered with glass blocks here so the pillager can't be seen by the villagers while in there. So as you can tell by the redstone here, it's really not complicated to build. It's only a little bit annoying in survival as you have this huge amount of loading blocks. But overall, considering the rates, it's definitely a good design to build in survival. I'll link Gnambon's video in the description, and if you need a tutorial for this, there are plenty on YouTube. Just look for Gnambon Iron Farm Tutorial and you'll definitely find one. On the Mechanist server here, we are currently using a 2-tower iron farm that has 6 layers each, and each of the layers has 6 cells with 3 villages each. So this is severely more dense than, for example, Gnambon's farm, but it uses portals to get rid of the iron golems, so we don't flush them away and kill them in the overworld. We teleport them to the Nether first, so we have all the iron golems from the different towers and platforms at one location. So also the item collection is way easier. We also use pillagers that don't have a bow anymore, that has been used up, because pillagers have a way higher range, so we can use fewer entities for more raids. The layers are not divided, so if these villagers on this layer spawn a golem on here, the villagers above that could also detect that golem, but this is in this case not an issue, since we have the pillagers visible to the villagers all at the same time. So the whole tower gets activated at the same time, so the villagers are synced basically. Also, each of the towers has a separate chunk loading portal all the way at the top, which also allows us here in the center to toggle between a 16k and a 32k mode. So if only one of the chunk loaders runs, we produce 16,000 iron power. And if both of the chunk loaders run, we produce 32,000 power. We also have an on-off switch, those two are separately. It basically works with these daylight sensors. The pistons block the light or let it through. And the daylight sensors are, as far as I know, also used to sync the towers and the pillagers with the villagers. In the Nether, all the iron golems appear in this portal. We update suppress the bottom two obsidians so they can just fall through directly into the lava. We also have some vines here, which we, by the way, also used for the villager cells to stop entity cramming and reduce lag. And then the items are collected with a hopper minecart, this one here. It just goes around here every time, and then it gets unloaded, and that cycle just continues. The items then get dropped here with these droppers, there's even still some in there, and then funneled and filled into shulker boxes. We also have a nice user interface, of course, you could just jump down here. And here we have the storage with the shulker boxes that I suppose somebody already carried into the main storage. We also have a small crafting station here, so we can directly craft the ingots into blocks, which is way more handy to store. And we can also get up here with a minecart elevator, a manual one, and here we get ejected automatically. That farm has been designed by Alu, by the way, and soon we will upgrade to a 6-tower farm, which has been designed by Ivey. So most of the parts are still the same, the towers are super similar, still the 6 layers per tower and 6 cells per layer. We just upped the count of the towers here. And this farm now produces roughly 80,000 iron per hour. Also the logic here has been changed slightly. We can turn this on here as we're on the on a single player creative world. And we should see golems spawning soon? Yep, there we saw some. In the Nether, the killing chamber also changed, so let's take a look at that. There you can already see. A lot of golems coming in here at once. I'll turn the volume down a little bit. Now, here we have the on-off switch. Let's turn this on then. These pistons push the items in the middle here. And those then get funneled together. Should be able to see that in a bit. Yeah, there all the items are coming in. And they get pushed onto here and shot over these sorters here with the slime block. Then obviously the iron gets filled into shulker boxes. And those then will be added to a storage that hasn't been added here yet. So as I said, we want to build this in survival soonish. We still want to do the decoration first, so that we can then build everything in survival. In the Nether, at the top here, we also have the chunk loading system. So here's the lever for that. I need to turn that on. And now the whole farm is also chunk loaded. Those are all Andrew's chunk loaders that I also made a tutorial of. They just cycle the island back and forth through the overworld and the nether, and they are super reliable. Back in the overworld, you can see the other sides of the chunk loaders here at the top. They are almost directly above those iron farm towers. And also what I already said earlier, you can see here the vines that the villagers are standing in to prevent entity cramming and to reduce the lag a little bit. Also, now that it's turned on, I should be able to show you, yeah, this. The block retracts for a bit, all the villagers get scared, they spawn golems, and then the block gets pushed on top of the pillager again. This cycle repeats for all the towers, obviously, and as you saw in the nether, there are huge batches of iron golems coming in. I hope you enjoyed this video, consider liking and subscribing, also don't forget to check out all the people in the description that made these farms, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye!